And of course, an excellent morning to you as well. Now, it's officially the first day of the first month of the year 2019, and we are pumped.
Absolutely excited.
Yes.
That
looks excited.
It's 2019. Yeah, I look like I'm ready for the year.
Yes, he
and you look very lovely as well. I'm liking. Is that denim?
Yes, denim and Ankara. You know.
Wow.
Starting the right
really
way.
Nice, really nice. Really, I'm liking the color and the bling that's coming out from there.
See, this year, hey, glory, favor.
2019.
Merci.
We're done with 2018, and we're focused on this new year. It's going to be absolutely special.
Yes.
Wishing you plenty blessings.
Yes, sir.
This coming year.
Favor, favor, favor. You people have been praying overnight, Abi. Don't worry. God has heard your prayers. And of course, we're going to be here with you as well along the journey. Thank you so much for tuning in once again. My name is Titi Layo Oyinson.
And I'm Yomi Okwe. We're live right now on TVContinental.tv. And when we say we're live, we mean we are live. We were in church last night, wherever else everybody was. I don't know where Mary was. But we were there, and then we had to come here this morning to just be with you live. And we are live right now, also on Facebook at TVC Connect. Now, for comments, you want to wish somebody a Happy New Year, you want to wish us a Happy New Year, use the hashtag Wake Up Nigeria.
Very important, that hashtag. And this year, that hashtag is going to have special impact in your life. So remember to follow that hashtag and, of course, follow us at TVC Connect. We're entering the new year with some amazing food as well. We will be having a chef this morning, eventually.
Eventually.
But Aunt Mary is going to be right there with her.
Hey, Mary.
I'm just going to pretend I'm the chef and Mary at the same time.
Really?
Hi.
Boy, if you need any help in the kitchen, we'll, you know.
Oh, you mean I would like to have you in the kitchen so you can take on the agbada by force.
Really? Mary. As in, I've missed you, Mary. It's like I haven't seen you since last year.
I haven't seen you since last year, technically. Like a week now?
That was the joke, Mary. That was the joke. Wow. Let's take this show on the road this year, people.
Yes, indeed. Now, of course, we mean to take on the new year like a boss. Or like chiefs and madams and, you know, whatever else. Now, Stephen Omojigbe is going to be up shortly to talk to us about what we should focus on in a new year like this.
Yes, so then we'll have none other than Janet Adetu. She'll be here for another etiquette segment. Today's topic is very important, decluttering. Let's declutter our 2018 lifestyle and get rid of it.
All right.
Start afresh.
Of course, if you were anywhere in Nigeria or about during the month of December, you will know that there's lots of stuff in the world of entertainment that has happened. And of course, MM and D1 later will be giving us all the updates.
Okay. My name is Angel Michael. Yes, sir. It was the collation officer for Tonto DK.
Of course, we can never forget music. Music is such a big part of the show. We'll be having Robinson here for a musical performance before long.
Never mind the fight, someone like you.
Now, Kehinde Adekoya is one of the women breaking boundaries in their chosen field. And of course, we'll be having a chat with the female mechanic much later on the show.
Yes, indeed. Nigerian singer, producer, performer, and songwriter J1 will be joining us as well for special New Year's performance.
My promotion this year. This year, this year, this year.
Now, as far as giveaways for this period, we got up to a little bit of something on our own. Our guards will be bringing you that little one on the show, I think, when we went out to give out some special stuff from TVC.
Road trip.
Daddy Santa, you're me.
It felt really nice, you know, being like Santa and Santa Mrs. Santa, you know, giving out gifts, basically.
Yeah.
But It feels like we've been given a gift, everyone, and Happy New Year to everybody.
So everybody looks...
It feels like we've been given a gift of a brand new
year. Everybody looks sleepy, but MM is just shining.
Yeah,
what's the secret?
That's him, MM.
Like, you don't look like...
eyes are red.
I didn't go... Okay, so my church doesn't do crossover service.
Oh, right, okay.
So
okay.
By 9 p.m., we're literally done. Well, I actually didn't go to church, but I watched online. Yeah, I joined service online because I was in the salon, so yeah.
You were in the salon?
Yeah. Yeah, and funny enough, I couldn't sleep till about 3 a.m. this morning.
Why?
I was just reflecting on my year, last year. Mm-hmm. It was a painful year, mm-hmm. and despite the fact that it was a painful year, my career basically took major strides, mm-hmm. which I'm pretty excited about for this year. So I was just basically reflecting, mm-hmm. writing down my goals and praying.
Good, and that's a good thing.
It was
that's a good thing. Last month in my church, we were talking about bringing in the sheaves and counting all your blessings and then ensuring that everything, you sort of line up all your ducks, put your ducks in a row and focus on what's
ahead. Lot of people make a lot of, aspirations, plan for things and everything, but they don't put things in place to make sure that those things can happen.
Right.
And that was what happened to quite a few people I know of last year. They wanted to do things before the end of the year, but they hadn't put things in place to
Some
make sure
people
they
put
happen.
Things in place, but it just doesn't work out the way they expected
exactly.
to.
Exactly. True. But
it's
a new
goes
year.
Both ways. Mm. Yeah.
It's a new year. Brand
Let's
new
be
year.
Positive.
Yeah.
Positive.
It's expected.
We're going to do great things together, though. As in, I feel like a real positive energy.
Yeah, we'll do great things like the news, for example.
We have to go to the news, and Ibrahim is on standby for us.
Compliment of the season to you, Yomi, Titi, MM, and Mary. It's so nice to see you guys in 2019. Prosperous New Year ahead. Well, President Muhammad Buhari has reiterated his many promises that the general elections will be free, fair, and credible. This was contained in his New Year message to Nigerians, where he rejoiced with his countrymen. But President Buhari cautioned that elections need not be a do-or-die affair and should not be approached with trepidation and mortal fear. He did not fail to acknowledge that the outgoing year had its high and low points, successes and failures, especially in the areas of security, economy and politics, but says his government is resolved to combat and overcome them all. He invites Nigerians to rededicate themselves to the vision of a Nigeria that works for all. And Speaker of the House of Representatives, Yakubu Togara, has advised Nigerians not to despair, but look to the future with optimism and absolute faith in God. In a New Year message, Speaker Togara says 2019 offers Nigerians a unique opportunity to strive towards making Nigeria work again. He also challenged Nigerians to be patriotic and committed to their civic responsibility by turning out en masse to elect credible leaders in 2019. And it's day four, and the police continue to lay siege to the residence of Senator Dino Melaye in the Maitama district of Abuja. The police authorities insist he has a case of conspiracy and culpable homicide to answer. Specifically, they are accusing him and his thugs of attempting to kill a police sergeant, Danjuma, in July. The police sergeant is said to have sustained gunshot wounds and is still in critical condition. Public utilities like water and electricity to the senator's house have now been cut off. The police insist that despite the warrant for his arrest, Senator Melaye must submit himself to the authorities. And the Taraba and Benue state governments are to grant amnesty to repentant kidnappers and armed robbers if they are ready to mend their ways before the end of January 2019. The decision was reached at the end of a joint security meeting between the two governments at the conference hall, Federal University Wukari. The two states have their fair share of attacks by suspected Fulani militiamen and armed bandits, which had led to the death of hundreds of residents. Taraba and Benue governors say their concern now is to contain criminal activities in their domains. Benue State Governor Samuel Otom says criminal activities in Taraba and Benue must end now. He disclosed that the government of Taraba and Benue have, for the past 2 years, worked relentlessly to establish peace, asking residents of both states to be more supportive. All right, that's all for the news. Well, let's take a look at today's January 1st weather, how it's going to look like.
All right, it's time for the newspaper headlines. Well, I think we have a couple of papers here that we'd like to run through, maybe starting with The Punch.
Yes, of course, there's a lot of Happy New Year celebrations on the covers of most newspapers today. On The Punch, it's the same, which is from Rotterdam in the Netherlands there, firework display. But the headline says NLC's insistence on 30,000 naira minimum wage unpatriotic, according to the governor's. It says here, Buhari to spend 1 billion naira on travels. That's 98 million naira on food in 2019. Interesting information on the first day of the year. North and Southwest moving against by 2023 presidential ambition, says Okorocha. It also says here, BRT drivers down tools over non-payment of salaries and bonuses. Gunmen attack Plateau, Kaduna kill 11. I dropped out of OAU, Ogun APC governorship candidate admits. It also says here, thousands to miss visa appointments as the U.S. embassy closes indefinitely. Nigeria won't grow without restructuring, says Afe Babalola. And that's what we have on the cover of The Punch.
All right, let's check out The Vanguard. And minimum wage, labor mobilizes for prolonged strike. We can't pay 30,000 naira minimum wage, governors insist. Say we can't use more than 50% of income to pay salaries. Lawyers, senators kick as police refuse to vacate Melaye's house. Sabotage fueling war against Boko Haram, says Army. And Nigeria's debt, foreign debt declines by 2%. Domestic debt inches up. New year, be optimistic, Dogara, Tinubu, Dixon, PDP can, others tell Nigerians. Don't involve military in forthcoming elections, can, tells federal government. And 2019, elections not do or die affair, says Buhari. A government shutdown, U.S. embassy halts operations in Lagos and Abuja. And Nigeria to expect 25,685 new babies today. That's according to UNICEF there. Wow. And then Naira up at 364 Naira to a dollar in the I&E window, says Naira Watch. That's what we have on the cover of The Vanguard this New Year Day.
25,000 babies in one day. Wow. Okay, so the Nation newspaper says Buhari to challengers, 2019 polls not do or die affair. Saraki, Dogara, Tinubu, Atiku, others unfold vision for the new year. And there's a large quote there from the president on his welcoming speech this 2019 morning. It says here, governors, labor standoff on minimum wage continue. And police justify siege to Melaye's home. That's what we have on the cover of The Nation.
All right, let's check out this day. Buhari, elections need not be do or die affair. I think I also remember another president saying that in 2015. Atiku, others preach peace, hope for better Nigeria. And then CEOs predict bright economic prospects in the new year. That's good news. And Labour insists on Tuesday protest over minimum wage. And seven killed as gunmen attack Plateau communities. And then there's a photograph here of the president in Kebbi State. Oh, well, Kebbi State Governor, Senator Abubakar Bagudu. And, of course, the Sokoto State Governor, Tambuwal. And the president during the president's condolence visit to in Sokoto recently to Shagari's family.
Okay.
That's what we have on the cover of this day.
The Guardian newspaper has an interesting cover this morning. It's very simple. 2018 Person of the Year, a goddess of resistance. And of course, there's a big blowout shot of Leah Sharibu, who has been tagged 2018 Person of the Year by the Guardian newspaper. It's quite a lot of information inside. I've actually opened it already, and there's quite a lot that they've written about her being a part of 2018 in a way nobody else could have.
Yeah.
It says here, it's a year to prove neutrality, Khan tells INEC. Then Benue Group raises alarm over influx of herdsmen, more on page 6. But that's about all we have on the cover of The Guardian.
All right, so speaking of persons of the year, we also have another person of the year on the cover of the Nigerian Tribune. But first, let's take the headline. Governors insist 30,000 minimum wage unrealistic. Say revenue to states down by 300 billion naira in 1 year. And then Tribune's person of the year is Aisha Buhari for speaking truth to power. That's a nice one there. You can find that story on page 17. In New Year message, Buhari again promises free, fair, credible elections. And of course, a couple of other stories there inside the Tribune that you will find. And then the same story about the 25,000 babies to be born today, according to UNICEF. So
that's
good.
That's a large number.
Yeah.
In one day,
25,000 babies. So we're growing quite fast.
I don't know what the ratio is as births to people passing on, yeah. But if you have 25,000 babies in one day.
Oh, no, we do have a huge and growing population.
That's incredible.
And growing population that is projected to be about 300 million in 2050.
Oof.
So we are growing very fast.
Wow.
So your kids.
Yeah.
Are going to be having children in about.
Of course they will. It's eventually.
About 18 to 20 years, depending on when they bring the boys home.
Boys? Well, really? Men.
Okay. Yeah. In about 20 years or so.
Okay, so there's quite a lot on most of the newspapers. A lot of impressive fireworks displays happened all over the world.
I wonder why they're using international fireworks displays.
I'm
seeing New York here. I'm seeing Amsterdam. That's Hong Kong.
Hong Kong, Sydney, Singapore, a lot of amazing displays.
None from Nigeria.
No comment.
Well, it's New Year's Day, so we didn't want to stress your muscles too much. We know that you guys are going to be eating a lot of turkey and stuff. So,
of course, in the kitchen, we have Chef Ayola. Now, she is with Mary, and they're preparing something for us for New Year's Day.
Oh, yeah, that's right. We're preparing something really, really good. You know, this year, I was trying to be as fit as possible, looking forward to the old fitness routine. And Titi decided to just come to the kitchen early today. I don't understand you. You don't want me to keep fit. Like, see all the flabbiness. Your time. All right then, you're welcome to the kitchen right here on Wake Up Nigeria. I'm not alone today. I've got Chef AY Subs right here with me.
Happy New Year.
She did something to her hair. I'm still trying to understand.
Yeah, shaved it off. Something new, something different.
This is actually a hair. Mm. She's weird like that. So what are we making today?
Like, this is one of them days that you know that we all went to church. Like, our man's is just trying to make the fastest meal before we go back to bed.
Girl, you sure you went to church?
Let's not talk about this. We're on air now.
Yeah, let's talk about it. Okay, so what are we making today?
I think this is one of the simplest meals I've ever made in my life. Yam porridge. It's very basic. It's beautiful. It's delicious. And it's filling. It will knock you out. Mm. So Nigerian yam porridge, but I do mine a bit spicier than normal.
Okay.
And then we're having grilled hake.
Grilled hake?
Yes.
Oh, that's why.
And you know you don't like fish, but you love this one. Don't worry, I got you.
Yeah. I'm a big fan of anything that has... Okay, this is fresh fish now.
Fresh.
So I'm gonna like this. If it was catfish as well, I would. Mm, but give me the.
I could have done that for you. You should have told me.
Sweetheart, keep it in mind.
I will.
All right, so we're making use of palm oil. What is in here?
Normal pepper, like blend mix. Okay. It has a bit of tomato. Normally, I would not use tomatoes, but it's not for me. I like pepper too much. So just tomatoes, onions, peppers, and garlic.
You touch blend it together. You like peppers too much. What else? Extreme.
Don't be acting like you know me so well, please, because you are going to be my husband. I'll just marry you.
I've never met her before.
I love her, by the way. She's my babe.
Okay, so we're also making use of crayfish.
Yes.
Okay, loads of this. And then seasoning cubes as well.
Basic.
Aha.
Very basic.
What's the first thing we're doing? Boiling or putting this in? You've seasoned this,
right? Yes, I have. Yes.
So it's marinating right now?
It's just marinated with stock cube and a bit of salt. But if you have anything else that you want to add at home, do it. Okay. Add as much as you can, but go easy on the salt and the stock, because fish is very temperamental.
Yeah, true.
Very, very temperamental.
True. That's true. Yeah. So you just keep it basic.
Very
just
simple.
Seasoning cubes and salt. But I can put in other things I want.
Anything you want, but don't put in as much as you want of salt and Maggie.
I can put garlic, like garlic
powder.
Beautiful.
Garlic works well with fish. But don't put... For me, though, ginger doesn't work with fish.
It always gives it a sharp of bitter.
There's something about ginger and fish. It just doesn't work out for me.
I think I agree with you on that one. I think so.
So don't put ginger.
The oven is heating.
It's been preheated,
right now.
But what I've done is, because obviously we're working with time here, I've put it on the highest temperature. Okay. As we know, fish is very, very basic. We need to get brown as fast as we want it to do. Because normally, as long as it gets brown, it's done.
Okay.
Like frying fish.
Yeah.
Once you see that it's brown outside, there's no way the inside will not be done. So I've put that on the highest temperature. Which you shouldn't really.
It's possible to have it brown outside and the inside won't be done.
It's not possible. It's not chicken.
It's possible.
It's not chicken.
It is possible.
What kind of oven are you using?
It's not oven I'm talking about. I'm talking about frying. Okay, so we're going to boil this with the sugar.
Yes.
We're making some sugar to boil the yam.
Yes, sugar and salt.
Sugar and salt. Yes. Oh, sugar and salt. Okay. So how are we going to make use of this?
What happens is, there are two methods. You can get your yam parboiled,
okay,
and then toss in the pepper with palm oil.
Okay.
Or you can do it my way. Fry your pepper first.
Okay.
So that get your yam to the level where it's literally done. You can eat it. Then you pour it in, mix it all up and steam it. That's what I'm going to do. Very basic.
Okay, so we're going to do it her way because she's the chef in charge, of course.
Yes, I am.
In the meantime, however, we need to go on this break. Stay with us. It's Wake Up Nigeria. Welcome back. It's Wake Up Nigeria. Happy New Year if you're just tuning in. Now, this particular segment I've been looking forward to. Clutter can, of course, make your space look really, just unapproachable and make you feel very, very uncomfortable. But did you know that there are different types of clutter in your life? Not just the clutter you see around you. Janet Adetu is back and she is our in-house etiquette expert. I like to call you that.
I've got to start by saying Happy New Year.
Happy New Year to you too.
Thank you so much.
You look amazing.
Thank you. Thank you so much.
All right. So, decluttering.
Yes, it's the new year and honestly speaking, it is time for us to declutter. If you want to start the new year off on a good note, you really need to start with, where am I today? And where do I really want to go? So I'm going to say start by decluttering your goals. Okay. So some of us walk into the new year with a whole lot of goals and we don't prune them down. And it's time for you to now say, what are the most important goals in my life? And pick five, even take the top three of that five,
okay,
and say, these are the most important goals or priorities for me this year that I really want to, you know, achieve. So declutter your goals. That means reduce them down to something that is meaningful, something that's very realistic,
okay,
you know.
So now we're decluttering our mindset, our goals.
Our mindset, yes.
But most people think of decluttering as a physical thing.
Absolutely.
But it is still part of what we're doing this morning, right?
So that is it. Mm-hmm. So then even once you've done that, you know your goals, you've decluttered them, meaning that you've pruned them down to the most important ones. I would say you declutter your home.
Okay.
First of all,
okay,
that means before you step out, before you go to the office, before you go to your business, start from your home. There are some areas in your house that you're probably thinking for a long time. If you had the time, you would clean this out, clean this wardrobe out, for instance. Take out some of those old clothes, those obsolete clothes, those ones that you're not using anymore or that you used 5 years ago. Prune that wardrobe down to the ones that you really need. Declutter your wardrobe, declutter your bedroom space, you know. There's some things that are just lying about. Old papers, newspapers, you know, even Christmas cards that you have now, they're all over the place. Declutter your room and give your mind some free space to be able to think,
okay,
all right? And even in, as we say, declutter your home, declutter your living space, the living room. And by decluttering, it might even mean renovating, touching up, painting some places, you know, shifting your furniture around, you know, declutter your kitchen, you know, that's the
kitchen
space.
Is a big
very
one.
Important
that's
place.
A big one.
Absolutely.
For me. I'm thinking about some old kitchen utensils I bought 5 years ago that I've just never used.
Never used
a nutcracker or something.
Yes.
Or it's just funny things I have around.
And you know, sometimes you throw things in the cupboard, you know, because people can't see them. By the time you open the cupboard and you say, oh my gosh, what's all this mess going on here? You need to declutter these things, you know. And I'm saying even when you think of your home, your living space, don't forget to declutter all the rooms are your children's rooms. Take out some old clothes that they're not wearing anymore. What's old to you is new to someone else, so probably give them out. You know, you might want to just rejuvenate some areas, change some colors around your house, you know, paint some walls, add some cushions, just to vibrate it. Then you want to declutter your office. Your office space. Some of us left our offices end of 2018 with stuff all over the place, in the cupboards, in the drawers. You ought to have decluttered at the end of the year before you come back. But if you haven't done that, it's not a problem.
Okay, so I'm thinking about the process. So these, we've gone through our house, our space, our mind one by one. But what is it that we actually mean by decluttering? So I know that, you know, tidying up is like cleaning. You know, that's cleaning your space. But what is it to actually declutter?
To declutter is to get old things out of the way and leave room for new things and create new opportunities. Okay. So let's say our desk, for instance, in the office. We have a whole lot of piles of files that were old. We're not going to use them this year. So let's take them away, put them somewhere where if we need to reference them, we can go back to them. Okay. Take out old papers, clean up our desks. It is it is an exercise of tidying up, actually. But leaving room for new things, giving you space for opportunity, and taking away those old things that you're not going to use anymore. So I'm talking about in your office itself, or maybe you have a cubicle, your desk, prune it down and get ready. Because if you're covered with clutter in the office, you can't think about new opportunities and you can't think out of the box. So I would say when you get to your office, the first day of your of work officially, just declutter it. Take out all those things that you know you're not going to use anymore, or the things that you don't need immediately, and leave space for it. I'm also saying declutter your car.
That one is
your
a big
car
one.
Has a lot of stuff in it that you really don't need, and you've been piling them up. Check your boot, for instance. All sorts of things in that boot, you know, in your the little
glove box.
Your glove box. You know, you really need to make sure that you take out things that you don't need. Old newspapers, files and things.
In about 45 seconds, can we talk about the advantage of decluttering in terms of, in reference to the disadvantages of not decluttering?
Yeah, honestly speaking, if you don't declutter, you are piling up junk. And sometimes you could call that hoarding. You know, when you keep on piling up old things, things of 3 years ago are still in your desk, still in your home, still around about the place that you actually don't need. And it's very important you declutter, because you're just going to compound things for yourself. And the act of hoarding, which means piling up things that you really don't need, is just going to create an act of confusion for you. Okay. So it's very important that you take things out. This is a new year, new goals, new opportunities, new things, new beginings. That's the whole idea.
Amen to that. All right, so let's get decluttering. Yes, now, we still have a few hours free time in this amazing holiday.
Yes.
It's a new year. Maybe you should take an hour or two to declutter.
Absolutely. Very important.
Thank you,
Janet. You're most welcome.
Thank you for coming to the studio once again. Now, we know that, I know that Yomi is on standby. It's all about motivation. We're still basking in the euphoria of the new year. Let's get motivated towards achieving new goals.
All right. Thank you so much, Titi, there. Now, of course, the new year is always seen as an opportunity to wipe the slate clean and start all over again, learn from past mistakes, get wiser, stronger. It's also a time of a lot of blessings, looking forward to the future and many, many things. Now, Stephen Omojube is here with us this morning to discuss what should be our focus for this new year, 2018. Thank you so much for joining us.
Yeah, thanks.
And for making it on January 1st.
I'm excited to be here.
I know it's a bit of a sacrifice.
Happy New Year to you, man.
Yeah, happy New Year, sir. I love this jacket.
Thank you.
It's fantastic. Now, January 1st.
Yes.
Lots of people, you know, lots of blessings, lots of WhatsApp messages telling you it's going to be a special year and all of that. A lot of times, most people, after hearing all of that, all the celebrations, going to church or going to the mosque, everything, you don't sit down and you just wait for something to happen.
Yes.
What should be my focus in 2019?
Fantastic question. So let me start with a quote. And the quote is this: the more things change, the more we need to hold on to the things that do not change. All right, so it's a new year, but it's an old world. All right?
Yeah.
It's a new year, but the price of success has not changed.
Wow.
So the things to focus on are still those timeless principles that are important for financial success, for marital success, for success in love, for success in your health. Mm. So while people are getting caught up in all the euphoria of the new year, which is fantastic, by the way, I mean, we should be thankful that we are alive and stuff like that. But you cannot afford to get caught up in all that and not understand that the things that will create a better life for you. Mm. They've never changed.
They haven't changed. Now, you're taking us into the classroom.
Yes.
This morning. So talking about this timeless principle, mm-hmm. it's almost like always going back to the basics.
Yes.
Beginning again, which is, you know, in the classroom now, you're going
to
tell us
exactly.
What it is.
It's always about going back to the basics. So I want to share with our audience today what I call the equation of life. Mm. Right. On the right hand side of that equation are the results people want. Okay. Marital success, financial success, whatever outcomes you have in your life. But this is what people focus on, the things I want to have this year.
Exactly.
That's what they're praying about, that's what they're excited about. But really what they should focus on is the left-hand side of the equation. Because everything...
So this here is the right-hand
side. This is the right-hand side of the equation, yes.
So this result, outcomes, what I expect at the end of the day.
The experiences you have and you will have, mm-hmm. which is what a lot of people focus on. But what you should focus on, actually, is the left-hand side of the equation. Because it is the left-hand side of the equation that creates the right-hand side of the equation. Mm. And now this is very simple. It's not rocket science at all. The things that produce our experiences and the results in our lives are three things. Number one are thoughts.
Thoughts.
What we think about. Mm. Number two are feelings. And number three are the actions we take. Mm. Now, let me just talk about them one after the other.
Yeah.
Thoughts. When I say thoughts, I don't mean some fleeting ideas that just pass through your mind. I mean the assumptions you bring to the world, mm. the assumptions you bring to the love life, the assumptions you bring to your financial life. So say, for example, you're trying to open that door. Mm. And you come to that door with the assumption that the door opens outward, so that you need to push it. Mm. But then you're wrong because the door opens inwards and you need to pull it.
Right.
So you can come to the door and you can pray and shout and be screaming and be pushing and motivate yourself. But because you have the wrong thoughts, mm. you bring the wrong idea, the wrong philosophy to that door.
And the door never opens.
And the door will never open. Mm. And you're going to be there, you're going to be frustrated, you're going to call a pity party, and then you get motivated, and then you do it again, and you get the same old results. Because until you change that assumption, until you change that thought, you cannot get a different outcome.
So this is a mindset thing.
It's a mindset thing. And what people should be thinking about this early in the year, first of all, look at your results. And ask yourself, what kind of thinking produced these results for me? Mm. And then look at the results you want and ask yourself, what do I need to change in my thoughts? What do I need to change in my assumptions? Because there's a way things work. Like I gave the example of the door. There's a way that door works. There's a way marriage works. There's a way finances work. There's a way health works. And you have to work it the way it's designed to work if you're going to get the results.
Hmm, I like that. So the next thing is feelings.
Yeah. Now, I use the word feelings roughly because it's definitely more than just some fleeting emotions. What I mean by feelings is, are you confident? Hmm. Are you happy? Do you have a sense of power and faith? Because the thoughts you have are not going to produce anything for you if they're not energized by your feelings. All right. So if you, for example, you come to the door. Let's use the same example. You come to the door. You come with the right thought. But you're feeling lethargic about life, which is where a lot of people live. Mm. They're expecting that when they get results, then they're going to be happy. So they don't enter into their daily lives with passion, with joy, with energy.
And they're just hoping results will happen.
And they're just hoping results will happen. Yeah. So even though they come through with the right thought, they push the door a little bit and it doesn't open. And then they give up because they're not strong in their heart. They don't have faith. They don't have confidence. Mm. Feelings has to do with your state. The state you are on a daily basis produces the outcomes you have. You go to a job interview, you have all the right answers, but you go there without energy. Mm. I always hire for energy, right? So two people come into the interview room, they both have the same degree, they both have the same competence. I'm looking for the one who is confident. I'm looking for the one who has a can-do spirit. I'm looking for the one who is
who's motivated enough,
who doesn't need me to wind him up every day. Mm. So that's feelings. And that's responsible for your outcomes. And then the third one, of course, is your actions. Because you can have the right thoughts, you can have the right feelings, and do nothing about it. Mm. All right. Now, these two things, thoughts and feelings and results, all of them, I mean, thoughts exist in the unseen realm. Results exist in the seen realm. The bridge between the unseen realm and the seen realm is actions. So it doesn't matter what vision you have. It doesn't matter what ideas you have. It doesn't matter what state you're in, you're highly motivated. Are you doing anything? Hmm. Are you doing anything? Right. So there's a saying that the road to hell is paved with right intentions. Hmm. Lots of people, year after year, they set goals. This year, I'm going to do this. I'm going to get a degree. I'm going to get a second degree. But never do anything about it. And until you act, and until you act strategically, until you take massive actions, when you burn your bridges and you commit, this is where you talk about commitment. This is where you talk about perseverance. This is where you talk about a spirit where you go into it fully committed. And that's what changes our results. So people should not focus on the results they want. Results will take care of themselves. Mm. People should not focus on whether they want to get married this year or they want to buy cars. They need to start asking themselves, what
having
thoughts
the right
do I
thoughts
need to sustain?
Coming with
how
the right
can
motivation?
I come in the right state every single day of my life? Wake up full of joy, full of happiness, excited about life, grateful for the things you have, because that's what creates massive actions that changes the results.
Wow. Wow. I mean, I wanted to continue this conversation, but it's absolutely amazing. This is what I needed to hear on the first day of the year. Mm-hmm. I know a lot of people watching us right now are saying to themselves, wow, I'm going to change my thoughts.
Yeah.
I'm going to, you know, get motivated in my feelings and then, you know, put my thoughts and everything into action.
Yeah. And then the outcomes will come.
Wow. Thank you so much, Stephen.
Always a pleasure to be here.
Happy New Year again.
Happy
once,
New Year,
once again. And hopefully we're going to be talking more and more about
Absolutely.
These.
I'm excited about it.
Wow. I'm excited about 2019 as well. Use the hashtag WakeUpNigeria. Talk to us. What are you up to? And what are your thoughts and your feelings this morning? And what actions are you going to be taking? Break, and we'll be right back after this.
Welcome back and Happy New Year, people. So yes, it's 2019. And of course, we're still going to give you a few, you know, gists on what happened, you know, towards the end of 2018. And joining me is D1, the comedian. Hi, D1, how you doing?
Hi.
Happy New Year.
Same to you.
How you
Same
doing?
To you. I'm good.
What time did you wake up this morning?
Man, normally I don't wake up early, but because of this program, I had to. Okay. I woke up 5:30.
All right. So let's entertain people. Let's give them, you know, let's refresh their memories on, you know, what went down in the world of entertainment over the weekend. Yes. So first of all, we are going to start with Aiko Bunaya's Big
Mama. Are we going
Mama
back to last
drama.
Year?
Yes. Unfortunately, we have to. I mean, 2019 just started. Up.
Yeah.
Come on. There's nothing fresh except someone decides to, you know,
to
surprise us.
Things.
But it's fine. Mm-hmm. All right. So Aiko Bunaya's Ogbunna's Baby Mama drama. So basically, he posted a picture of his baby, which we're not exactly sure if it's his baby or not baby, but apparently his ex-wife, you know, got, you know, upset about it, and she went on to, you know, so tell us what your thoughts basically about.
Well, I just, you know, marriage now, you really don't know what's happening.
Yeah.
You just see the drama on the surface, but then you don't know the real, don't know, but then I just feel she was being emotional. I mean, they share a baby together.
But she says that it's not his. She says the girl isn't his, that the girl is for somebody else, and that he shouldn't be posting pictures of them together. She even almost called him a baby snatcher. Go on. In the matter. Like, it's really funny, but I don't know what issues they are having, but I really do not think that she has.
I think there are a lot of things under.
That,
do you understand? But then this 2019,
right?
A lot of things will unveil, so we'll get to know later.
Right.
It's just a matter of time.
All right, great stuff. So yeah, we're moving over to Kanye West. So he goes on social media and is ranting about Drake following his wife. What do you have to say about that?
But that's social media now. Nobody say they follow your wife real life, you know? But then I feel Kanye is just a different human being. He can do anything, and then people say, oh, no, Kanye.
Yeah.
Just like me now, if I do anything, D1.
All right.
But
it
sounds like a jealous person.
Right, he is actually.
Maybe he's threatened by Drake.
Really? You think so?
You think so?
Yeah. Let's not also forget that he's actually staying off drugs. And like, he's like, you know, moving.
So now you're trying to say that.
Slate. So,
it's,
you know,
more
it's also,
the mental.
Yeah, it's also
that is
possible.
Mad,
you know, he's
temporary.
Has bipolar. So, you know, Drake just wakes Kanye West just wakes up in the morning and he's like, today, I got to shoot about something. I got it. And for him, he came forward actually to say that, you know, for him, tweeting is legal and therapeutic for him.
Yeah, like Trump.
Yeah. So, but let's listen to him. Let's just feel a little bit of Kanye West. Yeah.
Way up, I feel blessed.
Straight up.
I'm way up, I feel blessed.
Straight up.
Way up, I feel blessed. I ain't gonna say that we back or nothing, cause that implies that we're back from something. If we're back from something, it's some checks you owe us. I expect that payment, nothing less or over. I don't need them favors that you asked me for. I could give two fucks about where the Grammys go. I just gave out Grammys on my Instagram. Them OVO boys, the business, man. It is what it is. Trust me, you get what you give. Yeah. You gotta come to my side and see how we live.
All right. Great stuff. You like Kanye West?
I love him. Music. I love him.
Do you miss him though?
Yeah. We're quite close then. Before he
no, I don't mean like personally. I mean like, do you miss his music?
But most people don't know that we're buddies.
Right.
But then things happen.
All right. Great stuff. Moving over to Fino. Okay. So music critic and celebrity blogger Joey Akan actually called Fino out on social media. Yeah. Well, he didn't basically call him out. He just came. So we had a few concerts, that ended 2018 on a really great note. So we had Olamide's concert, we had Davido's concert, Wizkid, and Burna Boy. Yeah. And so in view of that, Joey Akan came forward to say that, okay, so Fino has not really been in so many conversations this year.
Yeah.
What do you think about that?
You know the way these critics behave now. Mm. What's your business, really?
Okay.
Fino has done well in the past. I mean, you can't reign forever. People were there in the business before him. Yeah. You know, you have your up and down, you know,
have
in the
moments.
Business. Exactly, you have your moments. But then, obviously, that's his job. He needs to also say something. Mm. But I just feel that it really wasn't necessary. The guy has done his own beat, you know. It just looks like you're comparing people that kind of thing.
So let's have a feel of Fino's music.
This beat ain't normal.
As I move from head to toe, I will never let you go. Hold me down and call me baby. Only you they make me go.
Yeah, and finally, let's not also forget that Fino actually called him a tribal fool. Making comments about him. It actually caused a stir on social media. Mm-hmm. And anyways,
and you now see Fino's fans. You now be saying, who is this guy? We don't even know him. Those ones will now say, then Joey's people will now say, it's true, he's right.
Social
media.
All right, so great stuff. Okay, so quickly, we have to wrap up quickly. Burna Boy, Olamide, Wizkid, and Davido's concert. Which was your favorite?
Burna Boy, because wow. I mean, it's new. I mean, Burna Boy doing a concert is new, so you didn't mention Wandeko's over then.
Well, no one knew about Wandeko's concert,
So Burna Boy, I'm not there. Burna Boy for me, then Wheezy,
all right,
then Wheeze.
Okay, so let's have a full of their performances. I'm not throwing shade, D1. I promise you. Because thank you, so much, D1.
You guys on this program, they very mean.
We are very mean, right? Don't mind us. We are like that. But thank you so much for joining me on this entertainment
segment.
Thank you
for having me.
Yeah. And I hear that you have a comedy show coming up.
Soon. This year.
Yeah.
This year is going to be. I'm doing 4 cities in Nigeria.
Wow, interesting.
Yeah.
Looking forward to that.
Yeah.
Exclusive.
Hopefully you'd sponsor. You have the money now.
All right, great stuff. Thank you so much, D1, for joining us. Okay,
yeah,
so quickly, let's get to Mary and J1 for a musical performance. Hi, Mary.
Yeah, hi, MM. Thank you very much. All right, it's time for a performance that is certain to lift your moods, get you into the new year feeling. That's if you already aren't. Every year, it's almost become a tradition on Wake Up Nigeria to bring J1 to sing us into a new year. And that's exactly what you will be doing right now.
Thank you.
Thank you for being here.
Thank you for having me. Yeah, we did. All right.
We're making money this year. No matter what them do, just be better this year.
Well, happy new year.
Yes,
it's new year. 2019 is already here.
New Year's Day.
I know there's some of you who are just waking up. I just want to tell you that we've been here live since 7 a.m.
Wishing you happy new year, back to back. All the blessings, all the love, friendship, new beginning, turning a new leaf, leaving old things behind. All those things. Yes, we've been
talking. I can't remember the last time I heard turning a new leaf.
Turning a new leaf. That's like changing the...
Making New Year resolutions.
Yes, so.
leaving the world behind. Mm.
We made quite a lot of great magic last year. And we made it happen, especially right here on Wake Up Nigeria. And we have no plans whatsoever to relent this year. So you might want to keep a date with us every single weekday morning. You know, we have a lot planned for you. Be part of the numerous things that we have planned happening right here on TVC at the hour of 7. My name is Titi Laya Oyinson.
And I'm Yomi Okwe. We are live right now. So this is not pre-recorded or anything.
Nope.
And of course, you can find us on tvcontinental.tv. And on Facebook at TVC Connect. Now, of course, you want to send a New Year greeting to someone.
Yes, please.
A Happy New Year to us over at Wake Up Nigeria. Or a friend, family, a loved one. Use the hashtag Wake Up Nigeria. Also use hashtag Happy New Year.
Yes, or of course.
Hashtag 2019 or whatever. Just say hi to somebody this morning. I'm sure that they will also be very appreciative to you.
Honestly, loads of great messages have already started pouring in. Add yours to the list. Maybe we might be reading those out later. Our guest today is one that we found very interesting. Now, by virtue of the profession that she chose, Kehinde Adekoya is a female mechanic, and she'll be joining us in a bit to talk to us about life as one, a mechanic in Nigeria.
And from that, Nigerian singer, performer, songwriter J1 will be back here to celebrate the new year with us. He's already done his special song this year. We're looking forward to something else.
Yes, indeed. And lastly, we have a small package for you. We'll be highlighting the door-to-door engagement we had with some of our ardent viewers of the show over the festive period. Right. So I felt that song though.
Yeah.
This year, this year. I don't know.
I don't understand the look on MM's face.
What?
while you were singing.
No, because I feel like we've gone past making New Year resolutions that we do not keep some of the time. Or
speak for yourself, darling. Speak for yourself.
Ah, please, please.
Speak for yourself.
Okay, well, no, come on. Okay, what? So what New Year resolutions did you make earlier 2018 that you kept?
Okay, so I made some, right? Some that I can't mention on air, right? Ooh. But I was able to achieve them in last year.
Okay.
Nice. Most of them. I said I was going to start something brand new. I did. I said I was going to keep up with some
I'm not talking goals. I'm talking New Year resolutions.
Yeah.
So resolutions which have like to do
things
with...
Things I used to do, I
exactly. Like lifestyle changes.
Lifestyle changes.
I don't think there's anything I want to get rid of.
I remember Fela Durote was with us on New Year's Day last year.
Yeah.
And as in 2018. And he gave his own personal experience about losing weight.
Oh, yeah.
And it was quite simple. He just said,
Yeah, so that's one of my goals for this year.
Yeah.
You said last year is 2018. Like, 2018 is gone.
It's gone. It's over and done with. Done and dusted. Old.
Get like with the 2019 program. Already.
Done and dusted. No, so he said...
I don't understand how you just, you know, change within just a few hours from 2018 to 2019.
Just one second.
It's just a few hours, though.
Just one second.
Yeah. And then you now say, New Year resolution. So now what will be what?
No, but I'm what he said was that he just said a target weight. And he said, okay, 85 kilograms now. I want to be 80.
For me, I think those are
August
goals.
August or something like that.
Yeah.
And then I think those are goals.
Yeah, well,
About decluttering earlier on. I think that goes towards it. You know, getting rid of old things, old mindsets, road rage, you know, screaming at your neighbor, screaming at your kids, maybe not learning anything new, all those kinds of things.
Well, there's something we are definitely going to continue on this show.
What?
The news.
Welcome back. Should we say Happy New Year? Happy New Year!
Happy Happy New Year. We're going to be saying Happy New Year till the end of the month. You know we have to say it back to back.
Yeah, all right. So female mechanics in Nigeria exist, but they are few, and you run into them every once in a while.
Yes, indeed. So when we met Kehinde Adekoya, it was important for us to bring her into the studio for her to share her journey with us as a female mechanic in Nigeria.
Wow.
Welcome, Kenny.
And Happy New Year to you.
Happy New Year to you, too.
Okay, so...
What lots of people don't know, Kenny is a mechanical engineer by training.
Okay.
And you call yourself female mechanic. Why?
Because I'm a mechanic. That's what I do.
That's what you do.
Yeah.
And we can see that you take a lot of pride in it. I went to your Instagram page at Kenny Rema, right?
Yes.
And I could see how passionate you were. You even give tips on how people can look after their cars. But then let's talk to us. Please talk to us about the journey, how it started.
Okay. When I was young, when my dad fixes his car, okay. I'm always the one he calls to come and hold the terminal for him to come and help him with the wheel spanner. Okay. So I've always wanted to be a mechanic.
Okay.
I don't just know why I just wanted to be a mechanic. That was why I actually studied mechanical engineering. I wanted to be a mechanic. Even for my JAMP registration was mechanical engineering, first choice, second choice.
Wow.
It was because I actually wanted to be a mechanic. I didn't know why, but I just wanted to be a mechanic.
And you were able to get there eventually?
Yeah.
Which university was that?
Olabisi Onabanjo University.
Yeah, fantastic. Okay, so I'm thinking about the female aspect to it. Now, you must have trained under a lot of guys.
Yeah, okay. My first exposure to being a mechanic, I actually trained with Lady Mechanic, the popular Lady Mechanic.
Okay,
when I got there, there were other ladies there. So it was during my internship in 300 level. So I was there for about 2 months. So after graduation, there was a particular day I was listening to radio. So they were interviewing a mechanic, that's the auto doc. So I was heading and I liked the vibes, the way he was talking about what he was doing. So I called him after the show that I would like to intern with him. So it was like, he doesn't have space. So on this particular day, I just woke up, I ironed my overall and I showed up at his workshop.
Wow.
And I said I wanted to work today, it was like. So fortunately for me, I actually met one guy who I knew.
Yeah.
So I started helping him out. So that's how I started working.
All right, so let's check out a clip of him talking about this experience that you just told us about.
I run an automobile workshop called Code Red Technologies, or Code Red Auto Shop in short, because Code Red Technologies is the big company and the auto shop is one business aspect of the company. So she had reached me several times on Instagram that she wanted to learn how to become a mechanic. And I wasn't so confident because I'd never trained a lady before. Most of my staff were male. And I'm like, okay, a female in this kind of field. I didn't reply her. She kept messaging. And I think she found out, she one way or the other, she found my address. So I got here one morning and I met her at the gate. As soon as I saw her, because I knew what she looked like on Instagram, as soon as I saw her, I was like, Jesus, my heart. So I'm like, okay, fine, come in. So she came in, she sat down, and I asked her, I said, okay, why this job? And she said, that's what she loves. You see, the thing about this job is not just trying to teach someone. If you have passion, passion costs your learning time, right? Because I don't believe anybody's dull. Whoever is not, whoever you call or claim is dull is not just in his or her comfort zone. So when she said she was interested in this job, I said, okay, I'll give you a try. I can't really promise you anything, but let's see how it goes.
Very nice. I like your passion and your determination because you actually went and looked for the guy and found him wherever he was.
So as a mechanic, I know there are different specialties. Some focus on the engine, some focus on things like the shaft and things like the suspension and all that. Yeah. So do you have a focus in that particular area?
No.
No?
I wouldn't limit myself because they all work together.
Okay.
So I do practically everything.
One of the things I'm curious about is your degree.
Yeah.
And its relevance to what you do as a mechanic. Now, a lot of the mechanics that we knew growing up in the 80s and the 90s
they do
came up as
error.
Apprentices. Trial and error, you fix this one, break this one. Mm. But how relevant is your degree and your background to being a mechanic today?
Okay, it's very relevant because I took courses on internal combustion engines. So I actually know how the engine works. I know the principle behind it. So when I'm diagnosing some faults, it won't take me a lot of time to actually know what is actually wrong with this car. Mm. So it has helped me fixing bad issues with cars. Yeah.
All right. So, it feels like a very daunting task, and especially when it comes to family. How did family react to you, actually going into this profession full time?
They were not surprised because I'm always fixing the generators.
Okay.
Like at some point, I'm always hungry that once there is anything, Kendi, the generator is not working. Kendi, come back. And I actually have a brother.
Okay.
So I'm like, okay, I have a brother. Why is it that? And my dad would be like, you are our Ebu engineer now. And my twin sister is also an engineer. She's a computer engineer. Wow.
Okay.
So she'd be like, no, that you are our engineer. Anything like Kendi, you can't do. So they were not surprised that I'm actually doing this.
I want to ask you a question about young girls today. So there's probably somebody watching you now and they're saying to themselves, okay, so this is why I've been passionate about this thing. Maybe, you know how as a girl you could be passionate about something that only guys do. And people are trying to veer you away from that so you can focus on more girly things. So what do you have to do to say to such a young
lady? Follow your dreams. When I was young, I actually wanted to play football, but my mom would not allow me.
You wanted to play football?
Yeah. Like I would always go to the field opposite my house. Like, I was always beaten for that.
Okay.
So now I used to tease her that maybe I'll be in Arsenal now. Like I have $1 million because you didn't allow me to do this. So if you have passion for anything, my advice for you is to actually follow your dreams. It will make you happy. There are times when I'm depressed, but when I go back to doing what I love, it fuels joy in me.
We'll talk to us about your business because you're starting your business now, and that is what's going to be taking you into your future. So talk to us about that one.
Okay, so I have a company, FAMTS, so that's Female Auto Mechanic Training Scheme. So okay, the plan of this company is actually train young girls who are actually interested in acquiring automobile skills and also run an auto shop by the side.
Okay.
So in 2019, I'm actually looking at training as much girls who are actually interested.
All right. Yeah. So that's the vision. That's 2019 in a nutshell
that's
for
the
you.
Training girls. So young lots girls. Of girls are going to be stalking you, just like you were.
They should.
You were stalking your former boss. So because pretty soon that will be happening as well. Lots of people who are inspired by your story and also want to make an impact in their own generation as well.
Mm. I really hope you come back and tell us more about this maybe next year and tell us about the young ladies you've trained. I can't wait to hear.
I would even bring some of them.
Yes, indeed. We'd like to talk to some of them as well. Kenny, thank you so much. You're an inspiring personality.
Thank you.
We appreciate what you're doing.
We should even have a segment on, car maintenance and stuff like that.
We'll bring Kenny as our in-house expert.
Yes, we should. Let's talk about that more later. But it's time for us to head over to our second performance for today. A double dose of J1 for this morning. MM is right there with him.
Hey, guys.
All right. Thank you very much, Titi. All right. So with me, of course, is J1. You heard him perform to his platinum single earlier on. So right now, he's going to perform into Ajay. Are you ready for us?
Yes, of course, I'm ready.
All right. Take it away.
All right. Can't lie, can't lie, can't wait no more. Can't lie, I can't wait no more. Can't lie, can't wait no more.
This 2019, something must change by force.
You already know what it is.
Interesting. What inspired that song, J1, quickly?
A lot of the times I try to think, for people around me and put people's experience into music.
Okay.
And when you hear people always say, like, man, something must change.
Yeah.
They need something to change. People complain, a lot, and you'd be like, okay, what can we do with this? How can we help the situation? The only way to help the situation is to put all these things into music so that everybody can understand that you understand at the end, there's always, you know, the light, there's always a light at the end of the tunnel. You don't have to give up. Yeah, it's always good to complain. It's always good to try to do more, you know, but definitely things will get better at the end of the day.
Oh, interesting. Very inspiring. Thank you so much. So we're about to serve your first food meal for 2019.
Seriously, I can't wait.
You can't wait, yeah? Mm-hmm. All right. So we're going on a quick commercial break, people, and J1 will be joining us in the kitchen. Stay with us.
So we're in the kitchen.
Yes, you're welcome. In the kitchen.
That song, Something Must Change. Mm. You know, it's very touching.
Thank you.
And it's not just even for someone who's about to commit suicide or anything like that. I was thinking about people who maybe 2018 was very bad.
For them, yeah.
And they're just thinking about what's 2019 going to be like. And those encouraging words.
I had to get my mic helping me to do that. Because I feel like, yo, I need someone who's got all the experience, who understand life better than I do, you know, to say those words.
Very deep.
Actually, it's for everyone. You can't give up. You can't, because you still have a whole lot ahead of you.
Yes.
You know, so, and I always feel like suicide is actually a very greedy thing, you know, because people don't even think, you feel like it's all about you. I don't know, it is not about you alone. There's a lot of people looking up to you. So you taking your life is like taking everybody's life. You know,
so 2019 is about hope. It's about hope, right?
Yeah. That's what it is.
Okay. Yeah.
And so, good food too.
Yes.
Chef Ayola, aka AY Subs, and she made this. Ayola, I hope you can remember what this is.
Oh, wow.
I'm on TV.
I just couldn't.
We don't want to see where Chef Ayola was last night.
I don't know what you guys, what are you guys doing though? Yeah. My mom watches this stuff.
Yeah, when I did you say anything? We didn't say anything, yeah. All right, so.
So what is this?
Even though not sour again.
Yeah,
porridge, man. Yam porridge. With hake, grilled hake.
And
then I decided, and then I decided I would do something extra with the stew. So I had a bit of sauce left over, and I tossed that in onions and essentially just fried it up and put the hake in.
All right, so
it sounds
J1 and Kenny are going to be
scintillating.
J1, have you met the lady mechanic?
Yes.
Fantastic.
So I can see Ayola is nervous. She wants to know whether this tastes as good as it smells.
I hope so.
So please, maybe this year will be good.
Amen.
This year. Yeah, I cannot wait.
This is my first meal.
Oh, please. And I hope it's not too spicy. You guys, I hope it's not too spicy for you as well. I'm a Yoruba girl, man.
I'm a Yoruba.
I put tomato because this boy always cursing me out. I want to kill them with pepper, so.
Are you serious?
My pepper. Oh God, you're tired of me.
Ayola is always putting extra pepper. And then we run from the food because of pepper. What do you think?
Spicy.
No, it's Yoruba kind of pepper.
Yeah, Yoruba kind of
pepper. Yoruba kind of pepper.
This is like ketchup for me. Compared to what I ate, this is like ketchup, literally.
No.
Really?
She's always extra. Just leave her. She touches hot things. Wow. It's peppery.
I'll go way back, so you know that I've always been like that.
All right, so while they're tasting the food, a big thank you to Homey NG for the kitchen accessories here on the show. But we do want to also talk about the giveaways that we had some time back.
Yes, indeed. Fola, you know we love you. Thank you so much for, you know, helping out with the hair. And, you know, it's been great having you all through last year. And we know that this year, Homely and Fola's Place are still with us. Thank you. We have to show you the highlights from our outing during this festival.
Yes, indeed. And it was quite nice.
It was amazing.
Tiring, but quite nice.
Oh, wow.
And we're just going to show you some highlights from what we did when we went out. And of course, we're going to be going out with
that. After that, we'll be seeing you tomorrow.
Tomorrow.
Yomi and Titi just
got here. Happy New Year.
Thank you, J1.
Hey.
For that beautiful and inspiring song. Thank you, Kenny, for joining us this morning.
Thank you. Lit, J1. Yes.
Well
done. J1, believe you guys made my New Year by bringing him on. Like, legit. I swear out. I'm so glad.
Thank she's
you.
Still turning up after.
Everybody. All right, it's the Christmas season, and in that same spirit of Christmas, the spirit of giving and Thanksgiving, we're going to see some families, viewers of Wake Up Nigeria, and we're just going to share with them some special gifts that we have from TVC Communications and also our friends over at Dufil Prima. It's going to be a special day, so follow us.
It's the most wonderful time of the year.
We have arrived.
Yes, we have.
In Mende, Maryland.
Woo!
This is Mommy P Stores.
Yes, it is.
Are you Mommy P?
Mommy P. Are you here? Wow.
Nice to
Mommy
meet you.
Mommy P.
Thank you. Well done. Well done.
Come.
Wonderful time of the year. Bring your bags of rice and all the turkey.
So, what do you sell apart from? I can see drinks. What else do you sell? What else do you sell? Eh?
A bottle water.
Dispenser. I sell gala, meat, then soft drink. Yes, yes.
I need that meat.
Fried meat, fried meat.
Yes, indeed. So this gives us you on behalf of Wake Up Nigeria, courtesy Dufil Foods. Thank you so much.
Don't fry enough meat.
I appreciate TVC. Merry Christmas and Happy New Year in advance. Of TVC.
All right, so we're done here. We're heading over to another house on this street. Or we're also going to pay them a surprise visit and also give them gifts. Right?
Yeah. We're about to surprise someone else this Christmas. We did promise we'd be coming to your houses, didn't we? Now, I know that the person we're going to see today has no idea we're on the way. Guys, let's go.
On behalf of Dufil Prima and TVC Communications, we're just wishing you a Merry Christmas and a Happy New Year.
Yes.
And we're giving you this small token.
So we have some car oil.
It's a lot. Oh my goodness. Thank you so much. Oh, thank you. Thank you so very much. We really appreciate. On behalf of myself and my family, the Anumbas, we say thank you to TVC. Thank you to Dufri. Thank you to Wake Up Nigeria, and thank you to you ladies and gents for coming. Thank you so much.
Going out giving gifts is not easy, man. How does Santa do it?
I wonder.
As in,
and you know he has to carry that big bag.
As in,
I'm
really
carrying just this. And
just awesome. Indomie and power oil and Dano milk, and we're tired.
Oh my gosh.
Goodness me.
Okay, so
we still have some more to give away.
Yeah, I think we're going to the cinemas now, Genesis Cinemas.
Yeah, let's see if we can find our way up there.
With the kids single belling and everyone telling you, be a good cheer. It's the most wonderful.
Hello.
What's your name? Omotoyosi, ma'am.
Toyosi?
Yes, ma'am.
All right, so do you watch Wake Up Nigeria?
Yeah, very.
Do?
Yes, every morning.
Okay.
Yes, ma'am.
So you know her name?
Yes.
What's my name?
Madam Mary, ma'am.
Okay. Minko?
Madam Titi.
Okay, wait. Let's see. So do you know what they cook today on the show?
Well, I watched a little bit this morning. What? I saw the woman doing something like chicken on.
Hey! You're very, very correct.
Well done.
Merry Christmas to you.
Merry Christmas to you too,
right,
in advance.
We're going to get this.
All right.
Yes.
Yes.
Thank you. Thank you.
Yes, so,
thank you, ma. Thank
so
you, ma.
You're getting Indomie.
Yeah.
Thank you.
You're also getting Dano milk and palm oil.
Thank you, ma. Very much. Yeah.
Merry Christmas.
Do you have anything you want to tell TVC?
Yeah, ma.
Yeah.
Merry Christmas and Happy New Year in advance. Yes. Thank you for all you've done. I really appreciate it.
Thank
I really
you.
Thank you very much. You.
I'm saying a big thank you to you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you very
All
much.
All right, let's dance it out. Let's dance it out. Who knew dancing in a costume of Donald Duck could get you a gift back from TVC? Wake Up Nigeria has been on the streets giving out gifts, and now we're gonna head back to the studio. Mwah!
Okay, so it's actually been a very, very exhausting journey this morning. We went to two families, a family and a lady at her store, at her shop. We also went to Genesis Cinemas. We gave out some of our gift packages at the cinemas. It was a worthwhile experience. Thank you for this, and Merry Christmas, guys. So, yeah.